Good morning, students. Hope you all are safe and healthy. Today, we are going to start the very first chapter of science, that is nutrition in plants. Let us start with the very first topic of this chapter, that is nutrients. As we all know that all living beings, whether plants or animals, need food to survive. The food contains nutrients in the form of carbohydrate, fat, vitamin and minerals, etc. So, nutrients help living organisms, number one, to build their bodies, number two, to grow up, number three, to repair the damaged part of their bodies, number four, to provide energy to carry out life processes. So, nutrients play is a very important part in our daily life. Now, let us start the next topic of this chapter is nutrition. Nutrition means intake of food. Nutrition is a process by which an organism obtains its food and utilizes it in the body. Plants are able to make their own food whereas animals cannot. So, depending upon the mode of obtaining food, all organisms can be placed into two groups, that is autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. Autotrophic nutrition. Now let us start with autotrophic nutrition. Autotrophic is the combination of two words, that is auto plus tropic. Auto means self and tropic means nutrition. That means self-nutrition. All green plants and green algae are autotrophic, means they prepare their own food. The organisms which show autotrophic nutrition are called autotrophs. So plants are called autotrophs. Next one is heterotrophic nutrition. In this, hetero means other and tropic means nutrition. It means nutrition derived from others. Well, the organisms that show autotrophic nutrition are called autotrophs. Let us discuss about autotrophic nutrition in plants, that is process of photosynthesis. Green plants are autotrophic, that is they can make their food by photosynthesis. In photosynthesis, photo means light and synthesis means putting together. So, photosynthesis is a process by which green plants prepare their own food from simple compounds like carbon dioxide and water using sunlight, which is captured by chlorophyll present in green leaves. So, carbon dioxide and water are raw material needed for photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide is absorbed from the air and water is absorbed from the soil. Sunlight provides energy needed for the chemical reaction. It is captured by green pigment called chlorophyll. Simple sugar like glucose is formed. Glucose is stored as starch in the leaves. Oxygen is released as a byproduct. Photosynthesis requires carbon dioxide, water, sunlight, and chlorophyll pigment. Hope you all understand the process of photosynthesis. Now I want to discuss some more about photosynthesis process, that how plants get raw material for the process of photosynthesis. It can be explained step by step. So let us start with carbon dioxide. How carbon dioxide will get for the process of photosynthesis? Leaves get carbon dioxide from air through the pores called stomata present on their surface. Each pore called stoma is surrounded by two guard cells, which you have seen in this picture. The guard cells control the opening and closing of stomata. When guard cells are open, carbon dioxide gas enters the leaves. Second one is water. Water is essential for the process of nutrition. Plants absorb water from the soil. The water absorbed is transported to the leaves through the pipe-like structure called xylem vessel. They form a continuous path or passage for water to reach the leaves. Plants also absorb nutrients along with water from the soil. The nutrients are present in the form of minerals dissolved in water in the soil. Third one is chlorophyll. Without chlorophyll, photosynthesis can't be possible. It is a green pigment present in the leaves of plant that capture the energy of sunlight. It is present in special structure called chloroplast. Each leaf contains 100 of these chloroplasts. The last one is, and very important, is sunlight. Sunlight is essential for photosynthesis. Even if green leaves get carbon dioxide and water, they cannot prepare the food without sunlight. Hence, sun is the ultimate source of energy for all living organisms. This is the overall equation of the process of photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide reacts with water in the presence of sunlight, and chlorophyll gives carbohydrate and oxygen. This is all about the process of photosynthesis. Hope you all understand what is photosynthesis. Thank you.